Hi everyone, welcome to Irish Crochet Lace, and today I'm gonna start the new section, new playlist dedicated to lace. This time it will be the French version of Irish Crochet Lace. It's called Le Picot Bigotin. I hope I pronounce it properly. Well, anyway, this is the classic sample that I bought online, and we're not gonna start with this one. We're gonna start with simple elements, and today will be the spinning wheel. That's the simplest version. And for this tutorial, we will need, I use this Alize Miss yarn and crochet hook, which is 0.99 millimeters, so just slightly less than 1 millimeter. And let's get started. For this tutorial, we'll need the padding cord, and I've used about something like, it should be about 25 centimeters. So I measured around 70 centimeters off the main main skein, and I folded in three. Also, I have this about 10 centimeters extra tail. We will need that to secure the padding cord inside the element, and we are ready to start. So what we do now, we have to make the chain of 14, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And, sorry, over this ring, we have to make 28 doubles. That's actually 27 because we do the first chain, and we do 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. You might think that you don't have enough space, but here comes the trick. You just pull the spare end, pull it tight, and shift the stitches a bit. Now we've got enough space to fit 8 more. 8 more stitches here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And we just do the slip stitch to the first one. We can now remove this tail. Very close to the work, but don't touch the stitches, don't damage them. And over here we have to make the wheel part, the race. Okay, and we have to make 7 chains, 3, 5, 6, and 7. We skip the first chain here, and into the second we make the double treble. That's in British, and that would be a treble in American. And we just repeat it, 3, skip, double treble, 3 chains, double treble, skip 1, into next, one, skip, double treble, 1, 2, 3, skip one into second, You might have already noticed that there is some kind of color code in my tutorials. So the modern lace tutorials come with the very colorful threads. The classic Irish crochet lace is made with fine and white yarn, and the French version is made with a matching color and matching thickness. So if you're watching if you browse through the videos, you can straight away tell which version of the lace you're gonna watch now. And again, skip one into the second, three, skip one into the second. At this point you might just want to count the stitches as 2, 4, 6, 8, 2, 4, and that's it. Three more, 2, 4, 6, 10, 14, and we'll do the slip stitch into the third one, into the fourth stitch. I think I've done the extra double here. That happens. Okay, so we add the padding cord. Remember this little short tail? So when we do the slip stitch through the padding cord and the double, this beginning part will be fixed inside and we can trim it halfway through, and also it gives you the equal thickness on the beginning, because remember when we fixed the padding cord from this side we folded, so this part might look heavy, this one is thin, so this little tail is kind of balancing. Okay, and over the padding cord and the three chains, we make six doubles into each scallop. That's three, five, and six, and into the next one, three, four, five, and six. Make sure that the padding cord is tight and the edge is not loosened. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Again, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, pull the padding cord slightly, just because the next row we won't increase the stitches, so the first row with the padding cord should be really tight, but at the same time watch that it doesn't fold the motif inside, that doesn't misshape the motif. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Some extra threads. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, and pull it. You can see this motif is kind of looking inside, inward, like this. So I have to probably overdone with the tension of the padding cord. Just release it a bit. And we continue. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Two, and that's actually two, four, yeah, that's right. We might just put this little tail aside, get it out of work, and continue. One, two, three, four, five, and six. So there's just two more left, three more left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we got very curious cat here. Likes to sit under the lights. Six. Yeah, six. And the last one here in this row. Four, five, and six. So we do the slip stitch into the first double under the padding cord. So the padding cord is included in our slip stitch. And now it's time to distribute the padding cord evenly. So the motif looks flat, like this. It's more or less okay from my point of view. I remove this little tail. Okay. And the last thing we have to do is another row of doubles. So we'll do one chain using the back side of the stitch. We do the doubles into each double of the previous row, like this. As I said, this is a very simple element. And it does look like a spinning wheel. I'm not even trying to pronounce the name of the pattern in French, because it's kind of, if I try to pronounce it, it might sound like a swear word in Russian. So, and so if you can see, got nice little ridge here. like this. And might want to use them somewhere later. You can also join these motifs together as you go, in case you know that you will use it in a line, just at some point where you know where your ends are. You just do the slip stitch to your motif on the side like this, or just remove the stitch and join it like this. There will be another tutorial on how to join elements on a go, something like this, but I don't need it right now. And we continue working. Make sure you don't skip the stitch and don't work on the over the padding cord itself. Yeah, I know the crochet hook is a bit old and lost in smoothness, so I haven't used it for about a year, but hopefully by the next tutorial it will be polished by itself and things go much smoother. Okay, so when we're about two-thirds done, it's time to start thinking about securing the padding cord. See, I need to pull some just slightly to make it flat like this. When you start working with the padding cord, you might crochet too tight or too loose, but as the time goes by, so you get more practice, you will come to the point that you don't need to think about the tension, it just does it by itself. It's just a matter of practice. Okay, so I'll probably stop over here to loop the padding cord. Again, make sure that it's tight enough to shape the motif. And just like I showed in the previous videos, insert the hook at the base of the row and pull the all three threads of the padding cord together. And distribute it evenly around the motif. Just that you might think, well, that's just about right. And fold it twice, bring it to the point where we had the working thread, and work over the two layers of the padding cord. as one. It does take some practice, but it's a good way to fix the thread, the padding cord inside the motif. And here we go, we almost finished the motif itself. So we've got 12 more stitches to the left. And we're just about to approach the base of the padding cord. It's getting more difficult to work, but you can figure your way through. And the slip stitch. Okay, now you can trim the working thread, bind off. Distribute the padding cord evenly. Remove the padding cord. And the only thing that is left is to weave in the end. And that's it. We've got the simple spinning wheel ready. So, have a good day. Have a good practice with your crochet and stay tuned for more videos and tutorials. You can click the subscribe button and this little bell button so that you get the notifications first when I publish the videos. So see you next time. Bye.